在艺术家的创意之下，任何材料都可以变成艺术品。来自澳洲的艺术家就用上百公斤的糖粉打造出一个梦幻的世界，有山丘，有湖泊，还有东方的美丽传说故事——牛郎与织女。艺术家说，糖做成的奇幻世界要保持干燥，不然可会招来蚂蚁，而且要小心，不要让小朋友一口把这件作品给吃掉了。
缤纷梦幻的小山丘，有的则是一大片粉红，有的则是绵延的青绿色。澳洲艺术家 Tanya 以 Pink Pop 为名，利用上百斤的糖粉以及亮片，打造出将近六坪的梦幻世界。
Well, I use sugar because it's beautiful. It's sparkly, and you can color it and make it really beautiful. But also because it has this desire for people. When people see it, they want to eat it. And so I think that it has this effect on your body, like as if you see something that you desire and you really want it. So I think that's really nice to use as a material.
先铺上白色的糖粉，再用漏斗导入其他的颜色，增加整体的层次，并利用宝丽龙、粘土以及塑胶玩具打造出高耸的山丘以及桥梁。每一件作品都是独一无二，甚至不能移动。他说，让糖粉保持干燥，就不会散发出甜味，吸引蚂蚁和昆虫。整件作品仿造东方的桃花源，里面还融入台湾的民俗故事。一大片彩色的湖泊旁站着一只小鹿，这是日月潭的白鹿传说。而两只小鸟中间搭起的七彩拱桥，则是大家熟知的牛郎与织女。
So I really love the idea of worlds that people kind of imagine, like a utopia or a paradise. Things that where the world is perfect, as if that you can have everything that you want and.Yeah, so I really love this idea of incorporating those stories into, I guess, my idea of a miniature world that would be perfect, that was sweet and beautiful and colourful, and you can eat it.
每个小朋友心中也许都有这么一座梦幻世界，不过艺术家笑说，家长千万要顾好小朋友，不要让他们把这片桃花源给吃了。